There's a snake checking in. I'm nearing the extraction point.
Snake, you magnificent bastard. Be careful. We got him till the alien life form is closing in on your location.
Roger that, Colonel. It's quiet out here.
How quiet is it, Snake?
Too quiet.
What's going on, Snake?
I've got company. Being chased by the alien life form.
Get to the chopper, Snake!
Alright, ready for takeoff. Here goes nothing.
As someone who loved building and playing with Legos as a kid, and loves flying and tinkering with motor rotors now, I knew as soon as I learned about it that I had to check out Flybrix. But because it doesn't really fit with my usual video structure, and other reasons that will soon become obvious, this won't be one of my usual full-length reviews, but more akin to a quick look or mini-review. As understood from the official website, Flybrix is the name of both the company and its product. The company being a three-person Silicon Valley startup, and the product a kit, of which there are two varieties for building multirotors out of Lego. A basic one with smartphone control only, and a quote-unquote deluxe one with a DSM2 receiver module and a rebranded blade transmitter. Included in both kits, you'll find a moderate assortment of Lego bricks needed to assemble the three suggested models, some original and some obviously custom, like these motor mount pieces. An all-in-one flight controller, voltage regulator and power distribution flight board. I believe this is a custom Teensy 3.2 Arduino compatible development board. 8 brushed motors with pin headers for easy attachment to the flight board. An assortment of propellers and a wrench for removing them. 2 single-cell 380 mAh LiPo batteries with low-C micro connectors. A USB charging cable. And a USB to micro USB cable for connecting the flight board to a computer. More on this later. What you won't find included in the kits is instructions of any kind, just a leaflet instead redirecting you to the official website, which hosts these in both printable and interactive form. The instructions are written with emphasis on experimentation, creativeness, and learning by doing. I think they strike a good level of information, informative while still keeping things moving, and for the most part, do a good job of guiding you through the process of building the three suggested models, a quadcopter, an octacopter, and a hexacopter. Whether based off the provided designs or your imagination, the process of putting a multirotor together is easy, thanks to the custom pieces that fits nicely with both original LEGO bricks and the ARC components included in the kit. The actual building process takes only 15 to 20 minutes, with the possible exception of the octacopter, with its 8 motors and as many wires to keep track of. Flying your finished creations can be done either with your smart device of choice over Bluetooth, or if you got the quote-unquote deluxe kit, the included or any DSM2 compatible transmitter. This is where you could say things, both literally and figuratively, start coming apart. Two things kept me from enjoying the flight aspect of Flybrix. Firstly, out of the box, at least when using the transmitter, none of my creations, not even the design straight from the instruction manual, flew well, responding either not at all or way too much, making flight for more than a couple of seconds at a time practically impossible. I figured this was a software issue and, sure enough, by changing a few parameters of the flight board via the official Chrome app, I was able to mitigate most of this. Secondly though, more often than not, the multirotors I build fall apart, either gradually in the air or completely at the point of takeoff. I don't know if this is the custom bricks being ever so slightly off in terms of fit, if the included bricks wear down a little with use, or simply that LEGO bricks in general don't have the right properties to support the weights and forces involved for long. What I do know is that this is the point where Flybrix started to feel less like play and more like a chore to me. This is also the point where this review kinda runs out of steam, not least because I'm out of usable footage and a little tired of spending 15 or so minutes of building for every attempt to capture more. As you probably already surmised, I can't recommend Flybrix. At the same time, I don't take any pleasure in bashing a small startup that seems to genuinely care about their product. While individual aspects, like the well-written instructions and reliable apps for both computer and smartphone may stand out, basics, like motor rotors that fly right and don't disintegrate, are just not there. There are also higher level problems, like who Flybrix is actually for. The tone and level of depth varies a lot between the different apps and sources of information. While this is spun as Flybrix being a product for everybody, I'm more inclined to think the opposite, except possibly people into electronics or coding due to the programmable flight board and open source code. If you're a beginner, the instruction won't cover all available features, and if you're more experienced, you probably won't see the point as you can just as well build a better, quote-unquote real multirotor for less money. Flybrix isn't crowdfunded, but it feels like it could have been. It has a great sounding idea and very polished pitch, which is fine as long as that idea works as well as it sounds, and all that emphasis on selling you on it doesn't come at the cost of the actual product being delivered. Sadly, I don't feel this is the case with Flybrix. Thank you for watching this short review of Flybrix. I hope you feel I did my due diligence, but as always, if you had a different experience with the product, I would be very interested to hear about it and would try to work it into the video somehow. Alright, see you soon in another review, stay tuned for the post-credit bonus scene, bye!
Ho 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 ho! Happy holidays!